someone's not motivated just because they look disengaged or not particularly interested. I had this training camp I was running, and at the start of the day, I thought, right, let's get them all running around the field, really warmed up, make it a good hard session, and then we'll go in and do some stuff on the judo mat. Now, when we were running around the field, I was expecting our top players, the top boys, to be leading, pushing it, pushing the speed, setting an example to all the younger ones. But instead, tap, 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 there was no connection at all. I was furious, thinking, what sort of attitude is this? You're in a nationals training session, and you're running, it's just a little jog and a chat. I was furious, I told them to go and get changed. But then later I thought, actually, maybe I need to have a little chat with them. I said, you know, why? Why? You're a good runner, you should be pushing it, you should be setting an example. And this athlete, who went on to later become Commonwealth champion, said to me, but you didn't tell us what we were going to do next. You didn't tell us what it was for. And I thought, oh, crikey, you're right. I didn't. So one of the things with motivation is getting an understanding, two-way, of what the goals are, and what their individual goals are, and what our goals are, and getting that communicated. The other area we've tried to work on quite a bit is actually building in some autonomy, some choice in the instructions in the work the training that we were doing. So autonomy is a key factor for getting that intrinsic motivation going. Now what happened? First, it didn't work very well. I remember running this session and I said, right, okay, your turn, you lot, I want you to practice and work on whatever you want to work on. And they looked at me blankly. The parents looked at me like, well, why aren't you running a session? These kids have been used to a very directive coaching style, and they were lost. It took quite a while for them to actually get comfortable with actually having their own opinion on what they should be working on, and actually having their goals and what they were working on, having confidence in actually that they actually had a say, they had an insight into it as well as the coach. But over time, they started to take that responsibility. And once they sort of got really engaged with what they're doing, they'd turn up and they'd start working at it even before the training session started.